3, 2, 1, go!
The 1517 to Paris is based on an amazing story that should take about 5 minutes to tell. Instead, we get a movie that feels so stretched out that it feels like the underwear of a 300-pound man. The story is the heroic true story about a train that gets attacked by a terrorist, and these three American friends take him down. That is it. It doesn't really give you a lot to go on for plot, does it? I'll admit, I wasn't really going to see this movie, because I thought, you know what, this sounds like it could be really stretched. And then I thought that the movie was only an hour and a half long, and I thought, yeah, you know what, they could do something with that, give these people some backstory. That's all they need to do. But boy, was this movie bad. I mean, I figured that since they got the actual heroes that saved the train to play themselves, that their acting wasn't going to be the greatest. And it wasn't. But you know what? They're not actors. But what was everybody else's excuse? The kid actors were just horrible. Now, true, the script for them was mostly the problem, but none of them sounded like kids. The parents all come across as stilted, and I really don't know what's on with them. But the biggest problem is there's simply not enough plot here for a movie. We spend the first half of this film with them as kids, mostly just blasting their school and all the bad things that their school ever did. This part, it's just confusing. I mean, there's a part of the movie where the boys get in trouble and the principal says to one of the boys' mother, "We think the boy should live with his father." And she, of course, gets royally pissed at the principal and leaves in a huff. But then the very next scene, the kid is going to live with his dad! Wait a minute, what? Did the school complain to child services? Did she come around to the school's point of view? Was this demanded by the court? Never cleared up. But you think that's the worst of it? Oh no, because the next half is mostly just these three guys' vacation and all the different stops they went to along the way and all the people they met. And I'm just sitting there like, what does any of this have to do with anything? I mean, I'm glad that these guys got to go on their vacation all over again for this movie, but so what? What does this have to do with anything? This part of the movie should take 5 minutes, not a half hour. And then after all that, the last maybe 10 minutes, if I'm exaggerating, is about the train. Which, of course, is the most interesting part of the film. Mostly because since these guys don't have to speak in the scene, as it's a lot of grunting, it really plays to their strengths. But there is a whole lot of nothing to have to sit through in order to get to something. Clint Eastwood, with both this movie and Sully, is seemingly trying to celebrate heroes. Everyday people who just stood up and saved the day. And you know what? I am all for that. We need more movies that show the best of humanity, especially nowadays. But you got to choose the stories that can be told in the time of the movie. I mean, Sully felt a little stretched, but the story fit in the space of a movie. This one does not. The whole heroic act is a guy running up and tackling someone to the ground. And it's a very heroic thing, but it only takes 10 seconds to show. This story would be much better served if it was either a short documentary or a half hour short film. But in the end, it feels like some Laffy's taffy that was stretched over a quarter mile. And that's why I have to give the film The 1517 to Paris a 3 out of 10. It doesn't have the plot, it doesn't have the acting, it doesn't have the writing or direction to make it worth your time. If you're interested in this story, look up news interviews. Or maybe after this movie comes out on DVD, look up on YouTube the clip of them fighting the guy on the train. It's probably the most realistic actually portrayal. There's no Hollywood stunts. It looks real. But honestly, looking at news reports on this subject will be way more interesting than watching these guys' backstory with horrible acting. P.S. Filmmakers, let this be a lesson to you. Never, ever let people play themselves. Because if you're not an actor, being yourself is kind of a hard thing to do.